G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today, and thanks for dropping by the water tank page. And what we're going to do here now is have a look at the best way to create the best rainwater you can from your own water supply, okay? With rainwater, you do have choices, okay? So rainwater's in the tank. The issues with rainwater is generally bugs grow in the water, the alkalinity, the pH level of the water. Rainwater is generally acidic, okay? So we've got to nail those, and the best way to do it is basically a filter. Now, on the page below, you'll see that you can get a 20-inch big blue 4.5-inch water filter in a twin, two housings. Generally, you've got a pleated and a bacteriostatic cartridge in there, 0.5 micron. Now, that's going to stop the bugs and the sediments and debris in the water, and it will also trap the eggs from those bugs, but it won't stop the bacteria. Bacteria probably down to around 0.2, so it's going to do a good job. If your tank's clean, you possibly get away with that sort of filtration. If your tank's full of leaves and pretty dirty and mucky, then it's going to be creating bacteria, and you really want to step up and go to the next level, okay? So the next level is going to be a very similar type of water filter, but you need the UV on there as well, okay? So it's the big whole house 20-inch by 4.5-inch twin, and there's a couple of ranges. There's the high pressure, which basically means if you've got a pressure pump, good pressure pump, just go for the normal high pressure twin MWF rainwater system, and that has a good block of carbon in the second cartridge, all right? That's what that system's about. If you haven't got the good pressure pump, or if you're on gravity, then take a look at the low pressure system, okay? Still got the good pleated system at the front, but we've got a lesser, skinnier cartridge in the second position there, so that you still get a good water flow flowing through that system. The water's filtered down to 5 micron, goes through the UV, bacteria, viruses, everything's sterilized and dead, and then you've got the water flowing into your home. You'll have a house full of beautiful filtered rainwater. None of those systems are going to help you with the pH level, but they'll definitely filter the water out for you, okay? If you don't want to use any filtration, then take a look at the HydroSil. There's dosing rates and everything on the page, so if you've got bugs growing in your tank or they're out of control, throw in the HydroSil. Make sure it's mixed at the right rate, but you can use the HydroSil, and you're still perfectly good for drinking plants, everything like that, no problem at all. Another thing, quick one on rainwater, is basically rainwater is acidic, okay? And it will eat out copper pipe. So if you can get there and elevate the pH of your water, that will stop it. So what you want to be looking for is in the bathroom, you have a white vanity basin. If you see blue-green staining on there, or blue-green staining in the toilet or the spa or the bath, that blue-green staining is generally copper. The acidic rainwater eating out the copper pipe, and that's where you're seeing it. If you do nothing about it, you'll find that eventually that copper pipe will start spurting holes through it. It'll just get eaten away in time. So if you have got acidic water from rainwater, you want to have a look at that. The pH elevation vessels are a good way to go. If you've got a concrete tank, the lime normally leaches out the walls of a concrete tank. It's enough to elevate the acidic rainwater up to neutral around the 7 mark, and you won't normally have any pH elevation issues there. But if you haven't got a concrete tank, fiberglass, aquaplate, plastic lined, plastic, you name it, they've got no lime in them, there's no interaction with the water. You've got acidic water coming out of the sky, acidic water falling into your tank, it'll be acidic when it comes out, and it will slowly eat away copper pipe, etc. Okay? There is a range of point of use water filters below. Some of them are UV, alright? So you can get a UV sterilizer on a water filter to go under the sink in the kitchen. Now, they work. Don't let me talk you out of it. UVs under the sink work, but I have issues with them in the sense that they've always got electricity on. There's always electricity under the sink. There is heat in one. So the UV housings get quite hot. And when you leave it for a period of time, you're going to get a drink out of your water tap, and the water has been heated up by the hot UV housing and the globe inside. So UVs under the sink are generally going to give you hot water. All right, you don't really want it, but you're going to get hot water. And if the power goes off, you've got no disinfection. I would much prefer people would use a ceramic or even an argon filter under their sink. If they do that, it's filtered right there at the point of use and they're good to go. The other thing you can do with a point of use water filter is to elevate the pH. You don't want to be drinking acidic rainwater, all right? The best thing you can do is elevate the pH by adding some mineral. 7 pH for water's gold, that's what we want. So with the point of use water filter, you can elevate the pH as well, okay? With rainwater, so all of those systems are going to work a treat. So just water's in the tank and we're treating it, drinking it, using it, no worries at all. If you want to create the best water you can, once again, it comes back to the structure of the water, okay? So this is no joke. A grander rod, okay? A grander rod, and you hang it in the water tank. That grander rod is constantly emitting a frequency. It opens the molecular structure of the water, it creates live water, it makes the available oxygen there, and then the bacteria hop onto that. The bad bacteria will be deteriorating while the good bacteria continue to thrive. You will slowly turn around, you'll build a whole ecological system there in your tank, okay? So by hanging a grander rod in the tank, you don't get this big heavy buildup. Obviously a first flush, straight off the shed, straight off the roof, a first flush so the leaves can blow or fall through and the water's taken over to the tank. That's the vital part of keeping a water tank clean. Trees are a bit of an issue, so clean gutters and a first flush, drop the water into the tank, a grander rod hanging in the tank. Once that water comes out, it won't have any bacteria after it's been there for some time because it'll just create its own life and it'll have the good bacteria in there that us human beings require. Water flowing into your tank house from there, I'd have a point of use drinking water system inside at the kitchen sink or wherever you're going to use it, and maybe even a big sediment filter outside just to hold any sediments and debris back. But grander your water after you have filtered it is the only way to go. Structured water for human beings. It might be rainwater, but I promise you, I drink rainwater myself constantly. It's all I drink nowadays, but that rainwater still goes onto a grander board, and then I'll treat and drink my bottles from there. So I hope that helps. Good luck to you, and give us a yell if we can help in any way. Just give us a ring. Nothing's a problem here. So happy to help and hear from you for anything at all. So have a good day. Good luck.